If a vote was held today, medical marijuana would be legalized in Florida. That's according to a brand new poll released today. WESH 2's Trevell Island live tonight. And Trevell, this is a hot button issue as we head into the 2014 elections.
Yeah, that's right, Sienna. So next time you're out in the streets, don't be surprised if someone approaches you and asks you to sign this amendment for constitutional petition. It's asking you to sign to legalize medical marijuana, and canvassers are hitting places all across the state, and they're paying as much as 30 bucks an hour to do it. It's a political issue that's now being taken to the streets.
Take the buds and break them up.
Every month, this local man breaks the law when he buys weed for his MS-stricken wife. She says it eases her pain. But the couple may not have to worry about buying marijuana legally if Floridian voters get what they appear to want. A new Quinnipiac poll shows that 82% of voters believe that medical marijuana should be legal. Only 16% disagree.
My father, 20 years ago, had a terminal illness. And was suffering terribly.
High-profile Orlando attorney John Morgan is leading a massive campaign to get an amendment on the November ballot legalizing medical marijuana for people with debilitating medical conditions like MS, cancer, and HIV. Attorney General Pam Bondi is fighting to stop the amendment, appealing to the Florida Supreme Court. State Senator David Simmons opposes it as well.
From looking at it, it appears to say that someone could have headaches and go and complain about having headaches. They could complain about not sleeping well and be able to obtain marijuana.
I think most people out here in TV land understand what debilitating means. It does not mean a hangnail. It does not mean sleep.
Well, that same Quinnipiac poll suggests that the majority of Floridians also believe that it should not be illegal to possess small amounts of marijuana for personal use. In Orange County, Trevell Island, WESH 2 News.